Let me show you how to use sciencestudygames.com. Step one, watch the videos that I've carefully selected that match the science curriculum. Watch the video, pay attention to the video. Step two, do the review games. Play the games. This will help you remember the important parts of the videos. Make sure you watch the video. Number two, make sure you play the games. And you're going to see questions that make sure that you are familiar with the key points of the video. The more that you see it, the better that it's going to stick in your brain. And then you get to play games. So play it over and over and over. So watch the video. Play the games. Then number three, go down and there's a quiz that you can take. So you've watched the video, you played the games, now you can take a quiz to see, do I know this information? It's going to be the same questions from the review games, but instead of playing the games in between, it's just going to quickly show you, do I know the material, give you an idea. If you get 100%, look, you probably have mastered this video. That doesn't mean you never go back and watch the video again. That doesn't mean you never go back and review the games, but at the end of the unit, you probably are going to come back. But for now, you can probably move on. Don't watch too many videos in one day. Don't try to knock out 20 videos in one day. Just a couple here and there. At the end of a unit, you go back and you play the games over, or you go back and watch the videos. If you get a 50 on this quiz, then you might want to go back and do the review games again, or you might want to go back and watch the video again. This is the system. Now, if you get 100%, go on to the next video, go on to the next games, and then play the games for a little bit, and then do a quiz. This is how sciencestudygames.com works. This is a strategy. A lot of people are going to criticize this, saying, oh, well, this is just basic knowledge. This is low-level Bloom's information. That is correct, but there's a lot of scientific data and psychological research that shows you can't go to evaluation, you can't go to synthesis, you can't debate these ideas, you can't analyze scientific ideas, you can't question, criticize, or defend scientific ideas, you can't present projects, you can't do presentations until you know the basic facts of these topics. You have to build on foundational knowledge. There's tons of information and scientific studies that defend this. There's a lot of teachers, a lot of college educators that don't like this idea. They expect everyone to give presentations and do debates and do giant projects and synthesize information. But before you can get there, you have to know the foundation, basic facts of every scientific idea. You need to know all the different ideas that involve structure of life. You need to know all the different basic terms and ideas that go with evolution. You need to know all the parts of a cell. You need to know all the bottom before you can start to go up and apply the scientific information, to analyze the scientific information. You can look at the information of E.D. Hirsch. These are all the books that he has written where he has basically hammered this idea away. The idea that, sure, it would be great to do evaluation and synthesis and analysis, but before we get there, we have to have a strong foundation. We need to know the facts. People hate, oh, well, you're doing drill and kill. This is just rote memorization. You're right. It is memorization. You must memorize the facts. You must memorize the terms. You have to go over them. You have to repeat it and repeat it and repeat it and drill and kill and drill and kill. How do you become a great basketball player? How do you learn to dribble? How did LeBron James get to where he is? He dribbled over and over and over. He shot thousands and thousands of free throws over and over and over. Free throw, free throw, free throw, layup, layup, layup. He hit the foundation. Now he's up at the top, but it started with the basic drill and kill. If you want to be a master pianist or violinist, you have to play songs over and over and over and over. You have to play scales over and over and over. And it's the same thing in every academic content, every different domain. You have to know the basics. And the best way to memorize the basics is to memorize the basics. It's drill and kill. It's rote memorization. You watch the video, you go over the games over and over and over until the basic facts stick in your brain. And once you know the basic facts, you can build on that foundation. You have to lay a foundation. You need a structure before you can start filling in the rooms of your house. E.D. Hirsch, you can look at the information. So that's what Science Study Games is. Watch the videos, pay attention to the videos, play the games to review that information to make sure that you got everything that you needed out of the video. If you're struggling with a game, then maybe you need to go back and watch the video. If you're playing the game and getting everything wrong, then you probably didn't pay attention to the video because the questions are directly from the video. The game questions are directly taken from the video. If you struggle with the game, go back and watch the video. Then once you've mastered the game, take a quiz, and the quiz will let you know you've mastered this content. You now have the foundation in that specific subject. You understand what an atom is. You understand genotype and phenotype. You can move forward. You now have that structure so that someday you can start to apply and analyze. Video, game, quiz. Video, game, quiz. Video, game, quiz. We lay the foundation, We build that strong foundation. That is the point of science study games. I'm not here trying to debate, analyze, do projects, do presentations, do creative experiments. I'm here. The point of sciencestudygames.com is to get that foundation, that background knowledge, get that up to par, get that onto a level where it needs to be so that you can have the opportunity to explore science.